from Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. The World Series on MLB The Show coming up. It's the Los Angeles Dodgers taking on the New York Yankees. John Shambi alongside Chris Singleton. And as we get set for Game 5, Chris, it seems like this series could still have a few twists and turns in it.
Well, being down 3-1, calling it a do-or-die game is no exaggeration, but these situations tell us a lot about a team's character, and for some teams, it brings out their absolute best, but for others, it kind of proved to be an overwhelming scenario to face, and so we'll see how they show up here today.
And we'll also get to see what kind of killer instinct they have on the other side. Some teams can get a little too relaxed when they're so comfortably in the driver's seat. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. So, almost ready to get underway. Showing the slab in today's game, Gerrit Cole.
Oh, this guy featuring that straight four-seam fastball, but off of it throws the cutter, and really he's most effective when he's using that cutter off the four-seam fastball just to miss the barrel of the bat. Not always going to see the swings and misses, but if you can somehow get weaker contact, you have a chance to collect some outs. Now, it's going to look the same until the very last second, so hitters are going to have to make a decision and hope that sometimes they're able to guess right.
That one finds the zone, and it's a full count. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Now a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Now it's Mookie Betts. And that's in there at the knees. That one misses. The count now 2-2.
It's a good take.
The pitch. Shohei on the go. On the ground to short. Throw on to Rizzo. No chance at the double play with the runner in motion. Time to check out the Dodgers lineup. This is a veteran-led lineup right here. A lot of players with plenty of experience, Singy.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Boog. These players have been around the game for a long time, and they may not have the flash that they once did, but they've got the wisdom to be able to understand different situations, be able to think with the opponent and sometimes in front of the opponent. And you always seem to see a team like this. They come to the ballpark, they know how to get down to business, and they understand what the job is at hand.
One out and a runner at second here in Game 5 of the World Series. Leaves it to Bender for the strikeout.
A pretty good break on the curveball right there. Maybe not as down in the zone as he would like, but deceptive enough to get that swing and miss. And if you don't catch that pitch out front on the barrel, it bears in on you pretty hard.
Here's Muncy to hit.
Two balls, one strike.
In the dirt, but kept close. Runner holds. Count goes to 2-1. Man at second. And it's even up.
So he'll have to hit and get his arms extended. Tie them up a little bit. Slightly up, slightly in.
And he struck him out. And that will end the inning.
Well, this guy competes hard. We see the emotion there. I love it. Great job of getting out of the jam.
Back now in the Bronx. And today's starter, Jack Flaherty.
When he's on, Boog, he's really fun to watch. He takes the pressure off entire lineups. And typically, he doesn't need a ton of runs and support. No one should be surprised if he settles in and takes full control of this game. That's what he's looking to do for sure.
We go to the bottom of the first. Gleyber Torres up to the plate. Pitch misses there. 2-2. Oh, great grab on the dive. And they get the out.
Well, he looks so comfortable making that play. Dives, comes up with it. And then from one knee, like he's just playing catch with his kid. Nice throw across the dive at first.
And now it's Juan Soto. One down, base is empty. And that's in for a strike. Two now to 22. Gets a piece and stays alive. Here's a 2-2. And that one is inside. Got it by him for the K.
Well, that's a blue zone right there, or the cold zone on the hitting chart. Just doesn't have much success in that part of the strike zone. And a really good job of the pitcher executing. Try to go there as often as you can. The numbers are in your favor.
Two outs, base is empty.
These hitters like this that have so much power, look forward to seeing them hit the ball a long way. But if you're in the stands, or you're in a broadcast booth, or you're a writer, better keep your eye on the game.
Battling here as he fouls it away. Two outs. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. Second inning coming up in the Bronx. No score. Back in the Bronx, new inning getting started. And now Teoscar Hernandez. A chilly atmosphere here. Really what comes to mind when you think of postseason baseball. Fans doing whatever they can to stay warm and energized. That one is upstairs.
You talked about the fans trying to stay warm, Boog, but it's a challenge for the players, too. Games like this really can be hard on you.
Popped up. Chisholm under it. Squeezes it. And there's one away. The batter now will be Will Smith. One down, base is empty. And that one fouled off. Second inning here, no score. Swung on, popped up on the infield. Drifts towards it. Makes the grab, and there's two gone.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
Two outs, base is empty. Kike Hernandez steps to the plate for the Dodgers. Two down, nobody on. And strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
inning of work there as he sets him down. 1-2-3. Nothing across here this half. We go to the bottom of inning number two. We're tied. Nothing, nothing. Back in the Bronx. We head to the bottom of the second. Now here's Giancarlo Stanton.
Giancarlo Stanton.
Good job to fight that one off. Here comes a pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. But why to kick the pitch? And another ball.
Well, he's having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
Center field. Edmund sprinting for this one, but can't get there in time. It's down. He saw a lot of pitches in that at bat and found a way to win the battle.
I don't think that pitch would have been called a strike, but he did such a nice job of pulling his hands tight to the body and just getting enough of the barrel on it to be hard enough back up the middle for a knock.
Jazz Chisholm Jr. now. Kicks and deals. And that one fouled off. Stanton on at first. Nobody out. And a pitch. Line drive. Base hit. Just kind of sliced that one into center.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. Kind of a that risky pitch coming inside with a breaking ball like that. You have to bury it. Otherwise, it's not too difficult to get the bat to it like he did that time. Runner in scoring position now and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
And here is Anthony Rizzo. The 1-1. Swings through that one for strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
And now it's 1-2. Fouls it back with two strikes. The Yankees looking to strike first here in game five. Adam. And that is a big first out. Anthony Volpe stepping in now for the Yankees. The 2-1. And that one missing low.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
Runners at first and second with one gone. Bottom half of inning number two. Up the middle. Lays out. It's off his glove. He doesn't have a play and they don't get the out. One down. And next for New York, Austin Wells. On a strike, the pitch. Up the middle, lays out, but he can't squeeze it. What a flip for one.
That's going to move right down the middle. Usually a lot of damage done with that pitch. A hard grounder, but he wanted to get that ball in the air, maybe drive it into the gap.
Here's Alex Verdugo.
There's a reason why he's at the bottom of the order, struggling as of late, but a knock here would be a huge lift for him and for his team.
That one misses. 3-1.
Love how this guy grinds out at bats. I mean, he's down there at the bottom of the lineup in the nine hole, but he's worked himself into a really good hitter's count, trying to pick up a two-out RBI.
That one finds the corner, and the count's full.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Corners are occupied with two down. Out to short. That's a base hit. Run scores.
Well done. Drives in the run. Just a simple ground ball the other way. They had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
Back to the top of the Yankee order. Here's Gleyber Torres. Two on, two outs. Here's a strike.
One ball, two strikes.
Two outs, and that just misses.
Really nice slider right there, sweeping across the dish, but just couldn't hang the edge.
And a swing and a miss, down on strikes. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. So it's two runs on four hits, no errors, and a couple left on. We head on now to the top of the third. It's the Yankees 2 and the Dodgers nothing. Back for more from the Bronx. On to the third inning. And here comes Tommy Edman. The wind in the pitch. Swung on, belted. Gone. He dunks it off the foul pole. He nails one out to right. And they're on the scoreboard. It's 2-1.
That gives this offense something to celebrate for the first time in this one. Well, he really crushed that thing down the line, and everyone had to hold their breath until it clanked off the pole. And every time that happens, it just kind of feels like a trick shot or something. But really, it's just a stroke of luck that it stays fair long enough.
That's a ball.
And another ball.
Well, you just got to delete it. You give up that leadoff home run, go back to work, focus on this next batter.
The 2-1. And there's a ball.
Three balls, one strike.
In there at the knees. Three and two now.
Two strikes.
The pitch. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. And here it comes. On the ground to third. To first. And that's the first out. Nice recovery after giving up the homer. Shohei Ohtani up to the dish. He is quite an athlete. I mean, you look around the other sports, basketball, football, you feel like he could thrive in one of those sports too. Pitch misses there, and now it's 3-2. Runs it up to 96 to record the punch out.
Well, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a called ball or anything. I just think he was flat out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
And another ball. Swing and a miss, and now 2-2.
Well, at that velocity, if that's all you're seeing, 88, you can handle that all day long. That's what you get in batting practice. But off the velocity of the fastball, that is a very tough pitch to adjust to.
Bounce to the left side. Jazz tosses to first, and Betts is set down. And that is that. Solo shot for the Dodgers this inning. And it's now a 2-1 ball game. You're watching the World Series on the show. Set for the bottom of the third. Here's some real power at the plate. Juan Soto.
I thought this was a fun note on Soto. In 2023, he hit home runs in Mexico, Canada, and the U.S. I don't think it matters where Soto plays. He's going to hit home runs everywhere he goes.
That one misses. And a count 2-1.
You know, these Yankees did a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way. And I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of them. They're doing a good job of working the pitch count. And they've been able to push a couple of runs across to score as well.
And a swing and a miss.
Still relatively early, but with a pair of runs already on the board, the ripple effect of that high pitch count might set them up to do more damage later in this game.
Two now. Chase that time. Swing and he breaks his bat. Hernandez hauls it in and there's one away.
The substitute, number 99, Aaron Judge.
Now it's Aaron Judge up to the plate. One out, base is empty. Next offering is in for a strike. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
And he'll be beating himself up on the way back to the dugout. Got a pitch to hit and just couldn't get to it. I think that slider really caught way more to play than it was supposed to.
Kicks and fires. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Oh, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. Stanton, the runner at first with two gone.
Helpful.
In the dirt, and the runner stays where he is. Two outs. And it finds its way through for a hit. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there. Pretty tough for the infielders to do anything with that one. He pulled it hard into the outfield. And even when you keep it on the ground, it feels great when you hit a missile like that.
First and second, two down. And stepping in for the Yankees, Anthony Rizzo. Two on, two outs. Good eye right there.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And a swing and a miss. And that ends the inning. Two left on. We played three here in game five. It's the Yankees 2 and the Dodgers 1. World Series game 5. And here's the first baseman, Freddie Freeman. A wind and a pitch. Little chopper rolls foul. The wind of the pitch. Got him swinging on the curveball. Now one away.
That's a pretty nasty pitch right there. I'd call it a power curveball in the 80s. It's got so much spin on it, and you really don't have a lot of time to sit back and watch what it's going to do before you have to commit. It was a good one for the swinging strikeout.
The 1-1. And downstairs. Swing and a miss as he was out front.
Baseball's coming out of his hand very well. He's been able to paint all four corners, but really good ride at the top of the zone. Hitters have to respect that. Very difficult pitch to hit.
And that one hammered. That's back there. And it's gone. And this game is tied. It's 2-2.
They put a good swing on it, but the box score might want to credit the win for that home run.
It's like he's playing wiffle ball up there, and that's typically not the easiest way to hit a home run, to the slight opposite field into the gap. Man, making it look easy, that's for sure.
Here's Teoscar Hernandez. Hey. Swing and a miss.
Two balls, two strikes.
All tied up, top half of inning number four. Just off the outside edge, and it's 3-2.
Really close pitch down around the knees there, and you could see him asking where it missed. Probably doesn't agree, but it appears he's ready to move on to the next pitch.
Foul off again, and it remains 3-2. And a pitch into center. Judge pulls it down. That's out number two.
It's a good recovery though after giving up the home run, not allowing it to stay in the head, but going to work at the next hitter, and a tough one at that.
And up to the plate is Will Smith. And that one a little below the knees. 2-1. And that's outside. Two down, nobody on. Ripped on a line. Base hit.
He was all over that one.
Other than ripping one into the gap or blasting one over the wall, there aren't a whole lot of hits that are more satisfying than a nice line drive in the center field. So that definitely felt good.
Here's Kike Hernandez. The 1-1 is fouled off. At the belt and fires. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Out number three. So they pick up a run on two hits. No errors and a man left. We're midway in the fourth. We are tied 2-2. Four, and the batter will be the shortstop, Anthony Volpe. Turned on, but foul wide of third. And it skips into dirt. The Dodgers bullpen with some action. Number 78 preparing to come on if needed. one inside. And a full count now. Payoff pitch. And that one is lifted in the air. Betts on the move. And it's caught for the out.
The catcher, number 28.
Austin Wells stepping in now for the Yankees. One down, base is empty. And another ball. And a big swing and a miss.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
In the air, right side. Betts makes the play. And there's two away.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite roll it up enough to really drive it.
Alex Verdugo stepping in now for the Yankees. Two down, nobody on. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. That's down and in.
Definitely a swing and miss slider down and in. He finished that really well. Just couldn't get him to offer at it.
Right through there for a strike. Delivers outside. Righty delivers. Swings and misses. Struck him out. Down in order, go to Yankees. Score remains deadlocked at 2-2. We go to the top of the fifth. Here's the center fielder, Tommy Edman. The 1-1. And there's a strike in the outside corner.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
Edman checks his swing, appeal to third, and he went around. Rule to swing.
The batter.
And now it's Gavin Lux. Base is empty, one away, and we're at the top of the fifth. Almost got him. On the ground, and that's just foul. One down, base is empty. Lux tries to check his swing. Now a look to third. Nope, he held back. 3-2. And that's ball four.
Ball four.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Here's Shohei Ohtani.
You can never say enough about Ohtani. In 2023, he became the first player in AL-NL history to hit 40-plus home runs and record more than 10 wins in a season.
Activity in the bullpen for the Yankees, number 98. Getting loose out there for Aaron Boone. Stroman also throwing. Not close with that one. It's 2-2.
This is one of those situations the infielders have to pre-plan and understand that the ball's going to be hit extremely hard right at them if they're going to have a chance to go for a double play.
Just missed. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
You know, the danger with the slider is leaving it out over the heart of the plate and getting contact on it. If you're going to miss, you want to miss towards the corners, not in the middle. Right there, he does a great job with hard break at the end. He ran it inside. Very difficult to do anything when you're tied up like that as a hitter.
Here's Mookie to hit. Turns and fires to Betts. Runner takes off. Throw safe. Chris's wheels were the difference maker on that play. Just got in there.
Yeah, with Statcast's help, we see his top speed on this stolen base, and that's a big number. I mean, man, he really made his athleticism work for him on that one.
The 2-1. Clips a corner. Runner at second, two down. Tapped out front of the plate. Throw on to Rizzo, and Betts is gone. That ends the frame. No runs on no hits, no errors, and a runner left. Last half of the fifth coming up. We are tied 2-2. Back now to start the bottom of the fifth and taking over on the mound, number 78.
Well, they didn't get much length out of their starter in this one, so they've got a lot of outs to eat up in that bullpen. I think they'll look for some length out of him right here if they can get it.
Gleyber Torres stepping in now for the Yankees.
The second baseman, Gleyber Torres.
Right-handed reliever. And another ball.
You know, these Yankees just lacking discipline at the plate in this ballgame. They've been chasing pitches outside the zone.
Down the line. Betts drifts towards it, reaches for it, but it's foul. Good take by Torres. We'll see another payoff pitch.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit. Just not able to square it up.
Now fly ball to right center. Edmund going after it. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down.
The right field.
Juan Soto now.
Soto.
Left-hand hitter waits. On the ground to first, and it goes just foul. All tied up, last half of inning number five. Next offering misses down and away.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Got him swinging for the strikeout. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. Here comes Aaron Judge.
Aaron Judge.
Yeah, the 2-1 hammered but foul. Two outs. Foul tip into the mitt, struck him out. Yanks held in check. Score remains 2-2. We're back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, number 98.
Now pitching for the Yankees, number 98, Will Warren.
Freddie Freeman up to the dish.
The first base is number 5. Freddie Freeman.
The pitch. Activity in the bullpen. Mark Leiter Jr. getting loose out there for Aaron Boone. Canely getting cranked up as well. This one high in the air to left center. Verdugo ranging after it. Brings it in. And there's 1-1. Here's Max Muncy. That funky Muncy. The pitch. In the dirt, ball two. Big swing and a miss. Verdugo running hard. Can't get there. This one lands foul. One down, base is empty. That misses the zone, and the count's full. And that's too high, ball four.
The batter, the left fielder,
Teoscar Hernandez, getting ready to hit.
Classic pitch sequencing there to change eye levels for the punch out. That fastball on the pitch before was off. It was very competitive, and that gets you thinking that he might try to climb the ladder. But then the curveball out of that same tunnel just falls off the table, and you can't make contact.
Will Smith, the next to hit. That's off the mark, and that's ball two. Two outs. Swing and a miss and a changeup in the dirt. Got him. Inning over on the strikeout. One left for LA, and this game is still tied at 2-2. Back at Yankee Stadium, bottom of the sixth, and now it's Giancarlo Stanton.
The designated hitter,
Giancarlo. And a pitch.
Stanton.
Now one miss. Activity in the bullpen for the Dodgers. Anthony Bonda, the left-hander, up and throwing. The 3-1. Late on that fastball.
Just threw that fastball by him, elevated, and if you're not looking up in that location, very difficult to catch up to, especially with that velocity.
Stanton swings, crushes one, out to left, and out of here. And just like that, they're out front. It's 3-2.
He ran the count full and saved his best swing for last. That was a battle, and he won. That one was a hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
Now, here is Jazz Chisholm Jr. Next offering in there for a strike. 2-2. Nobody on, nobody out here in the bottom of the sixth. And there's a rocket into the outfield. Around first, heading for two. Pulls in with a double, third hit for him today.
Well, that was one of those high percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. When you connect and it jumps off your bat like that, you're thinking double at the very least. What a great swing on it, and man, he wasn't fooled at all.
Anthony Rizzo steps to the plate. Here's a 1-1. There's a swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
Ground ball up the middle. Lux gathers and throws to first. One away, bottom of the sixth.
First of all, that's just a nice job to even get to that ball. And then even more impressive was the throw. Off balance, had to try to in the air, get his shoulders turned, and make a strong throw. Does show off the strength of the arm. We're usually used to seeing that kind of arm strength from the shortstop.
Got him swinging.
Not a big fastball on the mound by today's standards, just low 90s. But when you can pitch backwards like that and sometimes save the fastball for later in the count, it just sort of explodes on hitters and gets right by him. That was the first fastball they had batted, and clearly the timing just wasn't there for it.
And here's the catcher, Austin Wells. In the air, out towards left center. Edmund makes the play, and it's out number three. Giancarlo Stanton flexing that big-time power swing. It's now a 3-2 ball game. This is the World Series on the show. And welcome back to the ballpark. Now the batter now, Enrique Hernandez.
Both starters out of this ball game. It now becomes a battle of the bullpens and just seeing which manager can match up better and who's able to get to the finish line.
Drops into the glove, and there's one down. Tommy Edman at the plate. Holding on to a one-run lead here in the late stages of Game 5. Just missed. Looking to get the tying run on base. Strike two.
Two ball, two strike.
Comes up empty as he chases that one in the dirt. And there's two going following the strikeout. Tim Hill comes on now. Now
these are the spots where relievers really make a name for themselves. Late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Gavin Lux now at the plate. Even close there, and the count is 2-2, trying to hold a one-run lead here in the top half of inning number 7. Fastball almost got him there. And now the lefty swinging a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. Two down, nobody on. Swing and a ground ball out to short. And that is that. Nothing doing for the Dodgers here. They're down 3-2. Anthony Bonta on a pitch out of the pen here.
Bringing in the lefty with the left-handed hitter coming up to hit. Classic bullpen move right here, so we'll see how it works out.
Well, one-run game. Here's the left fielder, Alex Verdugo. The pitch. And he's swinging to miss.
One ball, two strikes.
And he hits a ground ball right side. He steps on the bag. One up, one down.
Now back, second baseman, Gleyber Torres.
Here comes Gleyber Torres. Base is empty, one away. Here at the bottom of the seventh. Gonna count one and two.
It might be time to choke up a little bit, get that front foot down early, maybe even just spread out. He's really late right now.
Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout.
Now batting.
Two outs, base is empty. Juan Soto digs in now. The lefty fires. That misses. 2-1. Yeah, there's a ball. Aaron Judge waiting to hit for the Yankees. That's a bullet, but it goes foul. Now a bullet to second base, but he's got it to end the inning. Three up, three down for him there. Eighth inning coming up. Yankees 3 and the Dodgers 2. Back at Yankee Stadium, ready to begin the eighth. Now it's the DH, Shohei Ohtani. The lefty ready, and a one-way. And a swing and a miss there. Moving in the Yankees' pen, Luke Weaver. The closer is getting ready and perhaps looking at a long save opportunity here. Holmes, a hard-throwing right-hander, up as well. The 1-2. Hard hit, left field, took the extra bases. Into second base, the tying run is on with a leadoff double.
Always feels amazing getting a job done when the team needs you to come through. It's just bigger than your own individual stats. Really stayed inside that baseball to send it to the opposite field. With the shift onto the pole side, that's an easy knock if you'll take it. And now a crucial opportunity to tie up this game with another base hit.
Here's Mookie Betts now. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. Can't get there. Should be extra bases. Here's Ohtani flying around third. The relay. He'll score and they've tied it. It's 3-all.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine. Another clutch run scoring at bat.
Yeah, he's been so good in these situations. Call it clutch if you want, but his resume speaks for itself. Looks like we've got a substitution at second. Pinch running here, Kevin Kiermaier. Runner in scoring position, no outs. Here comes Freddie Freeman up to hit. Left-hand batter waits.
Four extra bases.
Lots of anxious fans in the ballpark right now. You can feel it.
And it's second. And that one fouled off. Got him looking for the K.
Well, he's going to have some thinking to do when he leaves the ballpark after this one. That was his third strikeout. And this one looking, obviously. So he's been a little overmatched. He's got to find a way just to be more competitive up there at the plate.
And now it's Max Muncy. Popped up. He's under it. Pulls it down, and there's two gone.
Now back. Left field. Teoscar Hernandez.
Now the left fielder, Teoscar Hernandez.
As a pitcher, you know the runner on second is ready to push things with his speed. A base hit's probably going to be a big run, so you really have to execute on the mound.
Dives, but it's off his glove. See?
No, he did that.
Fantastic effort, but that extends the inning.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Just an awesome swing of the bat, quick hands, and just launched the baseball. 108 on the exit velocity. Man, that is coming off the bat pretty good. I know he's feeling good about it.
So out of the pen comes the right-hander, Mark Leiter Jr.
Mark Leiter Jr.
Will Smith steps to the plate for the Dodgers. Swing and a miss. It's 2-2. Two on, two outs. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Two outs. And another ball.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
Kike Hernandez in the on-deck circle. And the right-hander deals. Pops and misses. It's a strikeout.
Sometimes he wears the emotion on the sleeve, but that's okay as long as he's getting results. And right there, thrilled with the punch out to get out of a jam.
Now into the ball game on defense, Kevin Kiermaier. He takes over and right. To the mound now, they turn to Blake Treinen.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
It's Aaron Judge now.
He's a big, strong guy. Can untie this game with one swing.
And a 1-1. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
It's had a tough day at the plate. Three strikeouts already. It's hard not to think negative, but you got to find a way to somehow center up the baseball and put it in play.
Swings and misses. Struck him out. Here's Stanton now. One down, base is empty. And a count 1-2. Righty to the plate. Got him swinging. It's a strikeout. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
Very strong coming out of the pen so far as he punches out the first two batters he's faced in this one, getting straight to work. Man, it's talked about a lot, but relievers are just so electric these days. These aren't fun at bats if you're a hitter, and I'm so glad I'm retired.
And here is Jazz Chisholm Jr. And another ball. Two down, nobody on. Here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. Wouldn't chase that time. Anthony Rizzo up next. And the righty deals. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is, if you are the offensive side of it.
Swing and a ball lifted in the air, shallow left field, and that'll fall for a base hit. And that moves the go-ahead run to scoring position with two gone.
Well, those kind of lucky soft hits will always make you smile. He clearly didn't catch that one on the big part of the bat, just kind of muscled it out there. And you know, on the mound, it can be pretty frustrating for a pitcher, but you just kind of have to expect those to drop in there sometimes. And a huge opportunity now to grab the lead at this point in the game.
So two down, digging in, Anthony Volpe.
Well, if he's going to do something special right here, it's going to happen with two strikes.
Chisholm, the lead runner out at second. Dominguez at first, two out of the inning.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
And he deals. In the dirt. To third. Tag. Got him. And we stay tied as the inning ends. The Yanks lead one, so no change in the score. It's 3-3. Now into the game, Oswaldo Cabrera. He takes over as the new first baseman. Looks like it'll be a pinch hitter, Miguel Rojas.
And he's just looking to get something going any way he can here, trying to untie this ballgame.
Hard hit, right side. Takes it himself, and they get the leadoff man in the ninth.
That's a huge defensive play in the late stages of the game. It might not be the most challenging we've seen today, but it needed to be made. That's helping your team.
Now it's the switch hitting outfielder, Tommy Edman. In the air, left field. Verdugo ranging after it. He's got it, and there are two outs. And now Gavin Lux.
Now this guy, a player that if he gets on base has the ability to really be aggressive getting around the base paths.
Swing and a miss. And it's one and two.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. And it's a three up, three down inning. Nothing doing here this half. Bottom part of the order, 7-8-9, two up in inning number nine. All tied up at three apiece. So remaining in the game defensively, Miguel Rojas taking over as the new shortstop now following his pinch hit appearance. Daniel Hudson taking over on the mound.
They know that he can get a right-hander out, but he's in position to face a couple of lefties this inning.
And stepping in for the Yankees, Anthony Volpe.
Not shortstop. Anthony Volpe.
The pitch. That missed by the way. And the count is even, 2-2. The Dodgers bullpen with some action. Alex Vesia looks to be getting ready for manager Dave Roberts. Brazier warming up as well. Here comes a pitch. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
With that kind of velocity, an elevated fastball, even if it's still in the strike zone, can be tough for hitters to get on top of.
Here's the Yankees catcher now, Austin Wells. One down, base is empty. And another ball.
We got two balls, no strike.
The count 2-1.
That slider breaking in can be a tricky pitch. If you don't finish it and have that bite at the end and it stays out over the plate, it can get hit a long way. But that was a good one right there.
Oh, this one's blasted. High and deep. It's on its way. Okay. That one felt good. And the Yankees walk it off for the win.
Well, in the postseason, there's so much excitement, so much energy, everyone hanging on every single pitch. To have a walk-off win under these circumstances, these people have gone crazy. What a nice win, but you got to turn the page quickly to come back for the next game.
And the final score here, 4-3. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
Final line score tonight. First for the victorious Yankees, 4 runs on 9 hits. No errors. They left 7 runs on base.